So far, we have seen the introduction to the trees and what is meant by tree and how a tree will be constructed and what are the different terminologies in tree. Now, we'll see the implementation of a tree in C programming. I'm saving the file as tree.c. So as usual, that will program to demonstrate tree construction. Now, we need to construct a tree. So for that, the basic thing required is to create the node for the tree. So struct node. The tree may be having data. That is the tree node value. Node value of the tree. And every node can have any number of children. But when you are traversing or recreation of when you are inserting or removal, so we should keep track of how many children are there for the node. So for that int child count struct node, because we don't know how many nodes or how many childs will be there for every node. So that is the reason previously in single linked list we used to say next like this. So that means only one pointer, that is one reference can be given for one node, or one node may be linked with another node. But we require a bunch of nodes. We don't know how many children are there. So that reason what I'm going to do is I'm placing double star here. Double star in the sense here, that means I'm going to create an array of next pointers, so that according to the number of children that require for a node to create, that many number of nodes, that many number of next pointers will be created. So this child count, I feel it is too lengthy to write. So CC count, child count, I will say right now. For any tree, there should be a root. So struct node star root is equal to null. So initially the root is null. So this is the way how we can create the root. Initially root is null. If root is not null, then we can insert the element in wherever the position we require. Next, we'll write the functions like creating of node, create node. So in creating node, we require to place an integer value. So this is a function declaration. And whenever the node is created, the node reference must be returned. Struct node star create node. So thereby what will happen? The node, the newly created node will be returned. I'm writing a helper function to check whether the tree is empty or not. Is empty. If tree is empty, then when can you say tree is empty? If the root is empty, then tree is empty. Next, once we create the tree, we need to print that particular tree. So we can say print tree of struct node star, because we need the root node, so that once you know the root node, we can print the tree. So in order to print the tree, either we may go for any kind of traversal, like maybe in order traversal, pre-order traversal, or post-order traversal, that we'll see now in the implementation. Next one is, since we don't know to which node we need to insert the child, we require the root node and the child node value to insert into the tree. So that means we need to mention So to which node we need to insert the child node. So for that, so we need to write the child node to be inserted. Void insert child, insert child. So we require struct node. So while inserting, we need to have the double pointer, because we require root to traverse, and for the root child we need to create a memory there to create another node. So the reason for traversing we require one pointer, and for creating node and attaching we require another pointer. So we require double pointer here, and also we need to have the child value. So that is it may be some number or something. Next is this is with respect to particular node to child to be created for every node, but we want a function where we need to insert with a root, with the help of root, and to which parent we need to include this child. So integer, and so this is for parent. So we need to give the parent number, parent value. So we are going to traverse the entire tree and we'll search for the parent value. The corresponding parent value nodes child to be created as the value that you supply in this particular child. So these are the functions that are required for our thing. So here in this program we are going to see only the creation of the tree or creation of the child for a node. That will define the functions. Int is empty. So if so when can you say is empty, root is equal to null, then one else. Next one is creating the node. Create node of int value. So here we need to create a node start temp. Now temp is equal to node or malloc of size of node. The memory will be created just like how the memory we have created the single link list. The same thing we are supposed to do here. Temp data temp c count. That is now currently child count will be 0. Currently the child count will become 0, and when child count is 0, temp next is equal to null. That means currently we are not going to allocate any memory, so currently the next node will be 0. Return temp. So two helper functions, that is is empty and create node, function definitions are over. Next we will define insert child function. So void insert child struct nodes are int child value. So let will take a temporary pointer struct dot null. Here we'll be coming across the two cases. One is a particular node may not be having any child nodes, or a node may be already having two or three child nodes and new node to be inserted. These are the two cases. So for that, we need to check whether this root value, that what you are going to pass, that is the parent value, is null or not. So first we need to check whether it is null or not. If it is null, then we cannot do anything. Okay, if it is not null, then only we can do something into that. So star node not equal to null, then what we are supposed to do is that we will assign this star node to temp. And we have to check whether if temp key count is equal to 0 or not. That means there is no child or. So C count represents the child count. If the particular node does not have any child, then whatever the newly created node is the child node. Okay. Otherwise, we need to adjust the number of childs in that, and we need to insert the new child into the particular node. So here what I am doing to you is temp next is equal to temp next is equal to struct node star. So here I am going to use C alloc with one slot that is assigned to temp next. So that means I am going to create one node. Assume that already some childs are available, then else. So we are supposed to do temp next. So already some children are available for that particular node. So we have to create a new child for this. So that is the reason I am going to readjust the memory that is already allocated to that child links. So for that, what I will do is struct node star. Struct node star. So here realloc of. So how much we need to readjust? Which pointer we need to readjust? Temp next. How much we need to readjust? Temp t count plus 1. That means one new child is going to be added in here. So this is the way readjustment of the already existing memory will be taken place. Now create the new child temp next of at which position? Temp c count. So at the c count position we need to create a node with a child value. And after this, we need to increment the child count. Thus, we have inserted a new child. So this is the way child insertion is completed. Now we need to insert the child to a particular parent. This is general child insertion, irrespective of whatever the parent it may be. So now, if we mention a parent, then we need to traverse till that parent, and for that parent we need to create the child node. So for that we need to define the function insert child to. This function we need to define. So we'll define this child node in struct node star star node int parent value and int child value. So as usual, we'll write a temporary pointer, and we can do anything if the node not equal to null. If node not equal to null, then we'll assign temp is equal to star node. Now we need to create the we need to traverse the tree, and we need to identify the parent value, and for the corresponding parent value we need to assign the child value, and we need to traverse this. And first then starting node itself is the parent node that what we are searching. Data temp data is equal to parent value. then we need to insert the node to the we need to insert the node to this particular parent. That means we have to insert the child to the parent. So insert a child of this temp, that is the parent value and child value. Otherwise, what we are supposed to do, we need to traverse till the we need to traverse remaining children, and in that children, if you find any parent value and corresponding next or corresponding nodes child to be added as a new node. So else that will traverse all the nodes for int I is equal to 0, I less than temp t count I plus plus. Now recursively call this insert child to insert child to. One thing you remember in trees and in this non-linear data structure, we mainly use the recursion. Temp, comma, so here temp next we need to take a temp comma parent value comma child value. So here we need to traverse the child, that is next of I. That means whatever the child nodes are there, all the child nodes we have to traverse. So for that we have to take the child node addresses, and if the child node address maybe any one of the child node address become the parent value, so whenever it becomes the parent value, corresponding for the corresponding parent value, the child value will be inserted by calling this function. So this is the way we have inserted the child node to a corresponding parent. Now we'll define print tree, because we need to print the tree. And as usual, we will create a temporary node. If node not equal to, then temporary is equal to node. Then we need to print the corresponding temporary, that is the node's value. Data. And we need to traverse the children and children corresponding value to be printed. For int I is equal to 0, I less than temp in count I plus plus. So we need to traverse this and we need to print the values of children. Then recursively call this print of temp next of I. So this is the way how recursively we'll print the tree. Now we'll write the main method, void main. If root equal to null, if root equal to null, root is equal to create node, some value, we'll give some value here. For time being, we assume that the tree is like this. 10 is the root node consisting of childrens 1, 2, 3. And a 3 is the node consisting of childs 50, 60, 70 and 770. And for 50, there is a child called 65. So this is a tree structure. So that means we need to create the root 10 first. So create root node 10. So once you create the root node, then we need to insert the childrens. Insert child 2. First we need to give the root value and parent value and child value. So insert child 2, the root value ampersand root comma parent value is 10 and child value is 1. The same time for 10 you have root 2 and 3. So for parent 10, child 1, 2, 3. And now for 3, we need to create 50, 60, 70, and 77. So same thing. So 3, 50. For root 3, our parent 3, 50, 60. For parent 3, 70. For parent 3, 77. And for parent 50, we need to have child 64. This is 65. For parent 50, we need to have child 65. So this is the example tree. So just I'm repeating in comments. Example tree. Now once you do this, go for print tree. We need to pass the root value. Now we'll see the tree whether it is going to be printed or not. So here first root value to be printed. Next we need to traverse the childrens of every root and the children corresponding value will be printed. And if the children is having further subchildrens, for the children, then that value will be printed first, then we will come to the child node and then come to the parent node. So this is the way how the printing of the values will take place. So it is just like first parent will be printed, then children will be printed. So we'll run the code. Well, so first root value 10 is printed, next children's 1, 2, 3 is printed and the 3 corresponding children's 50, 65, 60 was printed, 70 is also printed and 50 is having the children 65. So 50 corresponding child will be printed. Next 3 is having further children's like 60, 70, 77. So all these childrens and parents were printed in this tree. Now in this tree we have only created the childrens, or we have created the childrens. So I am using some remove child. Okay, remove child of struct node star int. So this is the function I am creating. So you are supposed to remove the child, that is a remove node, you can say remove node. So here we need to be very careful. The removing node is the root node, then the remaining all children are sub nodes will become the orphans. So you must be very careful in removing the node. So instead of removing node, I will say remove child. So I'm remove child. So you give the child value. Child value should not be the root value, and you should traverse this tree and identify the child value. You may use recursion here. So if the child value is reached, then the corresponding child value must be removed from the corresponding parent node, and the parent node next size must be readjusted. So this is the task for you. So far I have done inserting the child into the node, or inserting the child into the tree. Now you remove the child, so by providing the root address and child node value. So you are supposed to traverse the list. You are supposed to traverse the tree and identify the child value, and corresponding child value should be removed. And once you remove the corresponding child value, the parent node's child count must be readjusted, and the memory should also be readjusted. So for that you are supposed to use realloc, and the child count must be reduced by 1. So this is the task you are supposed to do. You can find this code in the description section of this video. So this is the task. I hope you can do it. It is very simple. You should traverse the tree, identify the child value, and child value corresponding parent value should also be kept in mind, and the corresponding parent value's child size should be readjusted, and this child value will be removed from the child parent's child array. So this is what the tree construction. I hope you might have understand this code. You can download this code from the description section of this video.